historically, when we were thinking of kidney stones, we thought of it as an adult disease, and with the very few rare children that were affected by stones.
It seems that more and more children are developing kidney stones.
In the last 15 years, the incidence of kidney stones in children has doubled, quadrupled in some communities. And various reasons have been attributed: diet, the way we drink, what we drink.
It usually comes as a great surprise to parents that their child has a kidney stone.
They're almost always stunned for us to tell them that, yes, that what I'm showing you on this ultrasound is a kidney stone, and it's nothing to be afraid of, but it's there, and it's something that we're going to need to deal with.
And the best care for many children with kidney stones would include involvement of a number of doctors and other specialists.
The kidneys are two organs that exist in what we call the retroperitoneum. That's the space behind the belly cavity. They filter the blood, and by removing all the byproducts of metabolism, they ultimately form what we know as urine. And within that urine are all the waste products, or many of the waste products, that our body produces.
Some of those substances can crystallize and turn into kidney stones, which can get stuck in the kidney.
These minerals in the urine are like little snowflakes. So when there's too much of a mineral, or maybe something as simple as not enough water in the system that concentrates the urine, now there's more potential for these snowflakes to get together and form snowballs.
As they form in the kidney, sometimes they just can sit there, but oftentimes they can move around and then sometimes get stuck in the ureter, which is the tube that drains the kidney down into the bladder.
And they are pretty narrow tubes. And when a stone comes down, it's pretty much like a block sink. So the water behind it builds up into the kidney while the kidney is trying to push it down. This tug of war is what causes the pain and the symptoms associated with it.
This is a chronic condition which is likely to potentially recur over the rest of the patient's life.
By diagnosing and treating the causes of the stones, you can really make them better and, you know, make a major impact for the rest of their lives, that they'll be symptom-free and pain-free.
We're now seeing as many as 400 new stones a year between our nephrology team, our urology team, and all of the outpatient centers that we're working with.
This is really what would define an epidemic. That's a disease that at some point was much less common, that for many reasons is now becoming increasingly common in our population. So it's really that increasing incidence of kidney stones that drove us to develop this kidney stone center.
The center that could be the expertise in this, to zone in on what's causing this disease in our pediatric population and to better manage their care.